Hello everyone.
Okay, today I'm going to show you something new you can do with your Galaxy device. This works if you've got a Samsung Galaxy S3 and also if you've got the Galaxy Note 2 as well. In this case, we're using the Galaxy Note 2 and a Bluetooth keyboard. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to use a keyboard, a separate peripheral, to control the phone. Specifically, so we can play games on it. That would use a WASD setup, Enter key, shift and space. So your standard kind of third person or first person shooter controls. Now to do this, you need yourself a Bluetooth keyboard, turn Bluetooth on your device, and ideally, to make this work properly, your phone needs to be rooted as well. If you do root your phone, it tends to invalidate your warranty, go do plenty of reading up before you try that, etc. All the usual warnings. Now, if your device is rooted, you've got your Bluetooth turned on, you've got your Bluetooth keyboard, pair your keyboard up with your device. I'm not going to bother going through all of those steps. Plenty of other guides out there for that, and it's a really straightforward process. But basically, switch that onto pairing mode, turn Bluetooth on your phone, select the keyboard, stick in the pairing code that it tells you to put in, you are done and paired. Now, you need a piece of software called USB BT Joystick. And that basically stands for USB or Bluetooth joysticks. Now, what we're basically going to do is we're going to use this Apple wireless keyboard, and then we're going to map it to various touch controls that the games would use. So we need another piece of software. This first piece of software, the USB Bluetooth joystick controller, will cost you about $2. The add-on server, which is known as Touch Server, that is free. I'll put both of the links in the description so you can go and grab those quickly and easily. Now, once you've got everything paired up, you've got your software turned on, make sure you've got that yellow, and that yellow. And that's basically the IME, which is the keyboard interface. This keyboard will overtake any of the control of your on-screen keyboard. So a lot of your on-screen keyboard functionality just doesn't work properly. You need your Bluetooth turned on. Again, little yellow marker there. And this J2T, and that's basically the joystick to touch system. Make sure each of those are lit up and that your Apple keyboard is available. If you click on it and then press keys, you should see they light up. This is good. This means everything is working fine. Now, what we need to do is come down to the bottom here to Touch Edit M. We click on that and we're going to actually assign a key to it. We're going to assign this escape key to it. Our reason for this is when we're actually in a game, we need to map the on-screen touch actions of our fingers to physical keyboard buttons. And to do that, we need to bring up a special menu basically over the top of the game. And in this case, we're mapping it to this escape key. Okay, once you've got that done, then we go and fire up a game. So, press escape and this brings up our touch controls. And you can see I've already got some set up. Let me just show you that this is working pretty nicely. So I'm the one controlling, you see both my hands are here, I've not got a joystick off screen or anything like that that I'm doing this with. This is all being controlled with the keyboard. I've got my run button, my punch button, getting into vehicles, everything you need basically is mapped there and ready to be used. So how do you do it? So first you bring up this touch control. Now we'll get rid of some of these options first. For those people who I've already used this, I found that actually working out how to delete the damn things was harder than adding them. It seems no one has done a guide for how to actually change these buttons over. So the idea basically is that you're kind of mapping where a touch button would be required and then getting rid of it basically, or in this case adding it. So we'll just get rid of all of these. And basically to get rid of them you just need to touch the location where they are whilst pressing the button down that triggers it. Spacebar. Let's get rid of that. Ooh, long press. Okay, so this is now a clean panel. If you look, oh, it does actually, it's still remembering them for now. But basically, to add these on, all you need to do, for your first key, whichever your forward key is, press and hold that down, and then tap somewhere in the region as to where the joystick, the on-screen touch joystick would appear. So in this case it's going to be around this area, but make sure you don't put it too close to the side of the screen, otherwise you can find you don't get a full range of movement available. So in this case we're going to pop it there. Okay, so now if I do this you should see that these are moving, that indicator is now moving, but the other buttons around it are not. So that is working for a WASD setup, perfect. So if I come out of this, and that's working. You can see when the overlay appears, where my finger indicator would normally be on screen, that instead it's sending the necessary keyboard command to move you forward, and it will even work for the diagonals as well. So then what we need to do, set up our run button and jump button. Let's do jump first. So we press and hold down space, and we just long press where we want that button to appear. Perfect. For jump, let's do shift. For punch, let's do enter. And for getting into a car, let's go with one backspace. Let's just see if we can hop into a car, and we'll also put the driving controls in as well. Some games work better than others for this, has to be said. Something like Need for Speed Most Wanted, it's a little bit too sensitive, I've found, the controlling system, to really work well on a keyboard, which is a shame. First person and third person shooters work excellently though. So, now we're into the car, let's get away from here before they try and take the car back from us. Right, so going to there. And actually, you can see some of the buttons are still actually viable in this new layout, which is nice. We just need to add one for the horn and one for the bullets. So, let's do a horn option. Let's go with that one. And let's go with that one for shooting out of the window. And there we have it. And that is basically everything you need to... Oops. Put my foot down. It's everything you need to be able to play Grand Theft Auto using a keyboard. How easy is that? Like I say, you can use this with pretty much any game as long as you're able to emulate the touch settings on the top. So, once you've got all of your controls set up for your driving, for shooting out windows, that's it. You've got Grand Theft Auto available. You can now play it comfortably using a keyboard and mouse and loads of other games. A few people have been doing stuff online showing that, you know, the Galaxy Note 2 and the Galaxy S3 are phenomenal personal computing devices as well as mobile devices that, you know, once you hook these up to a large screen, you've got something equivalent to, you know, a modest games console. I just think in a year's time or so, what we'll be capable of, will anyone really want an Xbox or a PlayStation when they can have one device and just hook it up to a screen, keyboard, mouse, joystick, and off we roll? Personally, I don't think I'll be buying a games console again. This is absolutely fantastic. There you have it, Grand Theft Auto. Or any game you fancy, if you're willing to spend a bit of time setting it up, played on your mobile phone using your keyboard. Easy as that. In a future video, I'm going to show you what happens when we hook it up to a very large monitor or a TV and do a little bit of personal gaming in the living room.